neighborhood hope dealer, helping others prosper eternally. From hood to hood, block to block.
Reaching the unreachable, teaching the unteachable.
I am trying to be the modern day Malcolm X for my people. That's my goal. For the new generation, we got to be innovative. We got to be innovative and creative. All these book bag lies, food giveaways. Man, stop putting band-aids on the problem. We got to get you down to the real deal. You get a kid a book bag, and what? I ain't never known a big book bag to stop a bully. You feed a person one day, set up a tent, feed hundreds of people one day, because they hungry and they're homeless. What they gonna do to all the 364 days a year? Come on, man. That stuff is not a show. That's God's will. And we're playing with God's will. And you cannot play with God. Stop putting a band-aid on the problem. Today is a new beginning. I ain't gonna keep beating you on the head about what we didn't do. We're gonna talk about what we can do. First of all, you got to have parenting classes on a consistent basis. Because the reason why these kids are acting like they are acting, because the fruit don't fall too far from the tree. So, in my generation, you had to go to church. This generation, parents ain't going to church, and they ain't telling their kids to go to church. And without God and without the spiritual being in you, you ain't going to do nothing but the devil's work. Educate kids on why not to be in gangs, because kids think gangs is cool. One of the most things people overlook, a lot of our kids and a lot of our people in the hood, in the communities, in the improvised community, they need mental health services. Huh. A lot of people walk around, got a job, folks can drive a car, but you make them mad, their moms don't connect. I'm telling you the truth. So we gotta give our people what they need. Stop putting a band-aid on the problem. I got three brothers and three sisters. And we only been together, and I'm 52 of them. The youngest is like 32. We only been together as all six of us. We only been together like five times in our whole life. We have a dysfunctional family. Everybody mad at what somebody said, nobody wanna visit. Some of my sisters I ain't seen in 2-3 years. They mad at me for something I don't even know what they did. So I called my sister, I said, sister, we need help. We gotta go to counseling. That's some mental issues in Hope Dealer that I got to deal with. And my sisters. But you know what one of my sisters said? You need to go to home either. And a lot of people walking around like that. And what I say about grassroots experience, that means we don't make a strategic plan to solve the problem without going out there finding out what the problem is. When I wanted to do my homeless project, I bought cases of beer, went out in the woods where they was staying at, nobody on their building. I sat out there with them, drunk beer with them, in the cold, they had heat, whatever, you know, the little wood stove, whatever they had. For hours, I went out on the corner where they sleeping up under the bridge and went out there with a homeless sign, dressed as a homeless person, going up to cars, begging for money. I wanted to get that experience. That's what I'm talking about. Do the grassroots work first so you can find out how can you help. And you know what I found out? 75% of them don't want help.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I found out too? They don't want no business, they just want to get high.
That's right.
So I had to change my plan around. The first lady I met, I was breaking down in tears, crying like I don't know what Hope Dillon won't. He won't have it that day. Because she had broken heart. I was like, my God, why is this lady out here, you know, up under the bridge, sleeping? I said, baby, I'm going to do everything I can call the mayor and everybody. I got her a place to stay. You know what she told me? I don't want no place to stay. I don't want no place to stay. We put homeless people in a hotel for Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. Just so they can celebrate, we give them clothes, bring them clothes, food, their favorite foods and everything. We do the works. I have put homeless people in hotels and they don't even stay in the hotel. They leave as soon as I drop them off. So now I have to go back and see if they still there. They go sell the clothes and underwear and everything on the boat, but they won't even hide.
I went to cities and warned cities and said, this is what you must do. And they're all, we ain't that bad. Because I heard somebody in here say, they want to be gang members. How in the world do you want to be gang members and people die? Yeah. That makes sense. If people die, you real. Stop putting a bandage on the problem.
I can teach you how to hope. Neighborhood hope killer. Hope killer.